Today we have a look at some secrets and interesting facts about one of the most historic buildings in history. Here are 26 surprising secrets hidden inside the White House. Number 26. Catch some rays. There's a room inside the White House that has floor-to-ceiling windows, and it's warm, sunny, and a great place for the family to hang out at. Over the years, the room has served different purposes. For example, the Kennedys used the area as a schoolroom for their children, and the Roosevelts liked to have lunch here. Reagan actually spent a lot of time in there after his assassination attempt. Number 25. Outdated technology. Luckily, things have gotten a little bit better, but for a long time, the technology in the White House was so bad that the government officials were unable to connect to Wi-Fi in the Roosevelt Room, and watching live videos was out of question. Up until 2016, employees were using old black and white printers, old school Blackberries, and wait for it, floppy disks. The reason change doesn't happen quickly is that four different organizations look after the White House, so when change needs to happen, it takes a long time. But floppy disk long time seems a little bit extreme if you ask me. You'll be happy to know that by 2017, the floppies were finally put to rest and the White House is a little better equipped than before. Number 24. Call it what you will. Not everyone loved the White House. For example, President Truman called it a glamorous prison. Ronald Reagan had a different idea about the space and referred to it as an 8-star hotel. President Warren Harding liked to host poker parties there, while Michelle Obama grew fruit and vegetables in the garden. I somehow can't picture the current First Lady getting her hands dirty in a garden, can you? Number 23. Quick transition periods. This would be incredible to see in action and would clock billions of views on YouTube. When one president leaves and the new one enters, staff literally has 6 hours to transform the space. It's like the former president never even lived there. The whole process includes packing up the entire former first family and then unpacking the new first family, redecorating, which includes new rugs, headboards, paintings, mattresses, and the list goes on. And you only have 6 hours. The clock is ticking. Number 22. Secret code. We most certainly won't dwell on this, but it seems that when the current president wants to get intimate with his first lady, he uses some code words so that security and staff know that he may not be disturbed under any circumstances. Apparently, the code name for the president is Renegade, and the first lady is Renaissance, and when they decide to do the deed, they are discussing the Bosnian problem. No need to go into further detail at this point. Number 21. Secret rooms inside the White House. We're all aware of the Oval Office, the Situation Room, and the Press Briefing Room, but there is much more to the mansion than you wouldn't even realize. There's a movie theater, calligraphy office, music room, solarium, and also, we mentioned earlier, a game room. There's a basement area which has been described as a mini mall. It has a flower shop, a chocolate shop, and even a dentist. Number 20. The button. Sounds so ominous, doesn't it? Like the president is going to push a button and trapdoors will open, dropping an unsuspecting person down into a tank full of sharks. But no, it's nothing like that. I know, what a disappointment. The button is used by the president to bring a snack or beverage of his choice. Obama used to enjoy his cup of tea while Trump prefers a Coke. Number 19. Rent-free. Must be incredible to live rent-free, and that's how the first family does it. They occupy the second and third floor and don't need to pay rent. They don't get off scot-free though, and do have to pay living costs, like food and laundry. Number 18. Armed and dangerous. The White House has their own unique police force, and although the Secret Service has a tough job of protecting the President of the United States, the Secret Service Uniform Division has to protect the entire White House. The group was formed in 1922, but it was altered slightly 8 years later when Herbert Hoover incorporated the police force and the Secret Service. They were renamed in the 70s, and today, there are more than 1,300 people working in this division. Number 17. Settle up. There's no denying that the president makes a decent salary, but from his salary, he is responsible for all his expenses that include his food, beverages, laundry, toiletries, and basically anything. Staff are also paid time and a half when they work late for parties, and according to Jackie Kennedy, the president doesn't have nearly as much money as we're led to believe. The system works like a hotel, and at the end of the month, the president is presented with a bill. Number 16. Lions, tigers, and bears, oh my. Many unusual pets have called the White House home. Trump allegedly has no pets, and I believe that. But at one point, John Quincy Adams had an alligator living in his bathroom. Roosevelt's daughter had a pet snake named Emily Spinach. And Calvin Coolidge was the worst culprit of all, and he was said to keep a bear cub, lion cubs, a wallaby, bobcat, and a pygmy hippopotamus. Number 15. and the winner is... We mentioned James Hoban earlier on, and he won a competition to design the White House. It was 1792, and his inspiration was a villa in Dublin. There are other White Houses around the world where Hoban's design may have replicated. There's one in Georgia, Texas, and Virginia. In China, there's White House hotels, restaurants, and courthouses. Number 14. A costly affair. We mentioned earlier that the president pays for his own food, and although this isn't a secret, but more of a necessity, the president has to have all of his food screened before eating. You have to wonder the costs involved in that practice. The president buys something while abroad, it gets delivered to a staff member's home so that the package can't be tampered with before it reaches the president. Number 13. Ghosts of the president's past. Many believe that Lincoln's ghost wanders through the White House at night. Number 12. It's a bee thing. The White House has their own beekeeper. His name is Charles Brance, and he's been at the White House since 2009. He looks over 70,000 bees who assist in pollinating the kitchen garden. Number 11. Your wish is my command. There are definitely pluses to being the president, and one of them is the staff will cater to your every need. For example, it's said that Trump gets a little extra sauce with his dinner while the rest get the usual amount, and he always gets two scoops of ice cream with our tax money. Number 10. Building done by slaves. At the Democratic National Convention in 2016, Michelle Obama mentioned that the White House was built by slaves. Many people were not happy with her comments, but she was 100% correct. Congress confirmed that 400 to 600 workers were slaves. Number 9. Show me some skin. There have been a few awkward moments in the White House, many of which we're not even aware of. One book tells the story of an usher who was forced to interrupt President Reagan in the shower, and the usher said all he had on him was a skim of water.
Ew, gross.
Number 8. I'll drink to that. The White House has its own brand of beer. Sadly, we'll never get to sample it. Barack Obama enjoyed brewing his own blend and has produced 4 flavors. Trump doesn't drink, but maybe he would consider brewing his own tea? Number 7. When one isn't enough. The White House has a total of 3 kitchens. They have a main kitchen, a pastry kitchen, and a family kitchen. There are 132 rooms in total, 35 bathrooms, 3 elevators, 8 staircases, and 6 different levels. Number 6. It used to be a martial arts dojo. Such a bizarre bit of information, but it's the truth. During the early 1900s, the White House was also used as a martial arts dojo. The sensei was none other than Theodore Roosevelt, who was considered the manliest president in US history. Number 5. Word of mouth. Have you ever seen a job advertisement for a place as a staff member of the White House? No? That's because there never has ever been one. Random people cannot get a job there, and it's only by recommendations of the staff already working there that people can get employed. Number 4. What's in a name? The White House wasn't always called the White House. Before, Roosevelt even called it the Executive Mansion, but it also has been known as the President's House. Very original. And also the President's Castle. It was Theodore Roosevelt that called it the White House, and it's remained ever since. Number 3. Here to stay. When the West Wing was built, no one expected it to stick around forever. Theodore Roosevelt wanted to separate his work and home life, so he had a new area built, originally called the Executive Office Building. The name eventually changed to the West Wing, which William Howard Taft made bigger and remodeled. Part of the remodeling saw that the president's office be changed into an oval, which is now today's Oval Office. Number 2. Bearer of gifts. Tom Hanks has allegedly given the White House 2 coffee makers. He had picked up on the lack of espresso maker in the press room, so he bought one for them. When he went there back in 2010, he took the old one away and bought them a new one. And number 1. Joke's on you. It's been said that when one president leaves and a new one takes over, the staff play little jokes on the new president. Bill Clinton's aide allegedly caused $40,000 worth of damage for the account of the George Bush team that entered the White House. The W key was pulled off of 62 keyboards. Drawers were glued shut and lewd messages left on the phones. Whether this is 100% true, I guess we'll never know.